we're going to work a basic conversion. We're going to go from 23.4 centimeters to meters. Maybe you look at this and you go, well, I don't have to do any work. I know what the answer is right now. The reason for showing this problem is to start with a relatively simple problem in terms of number of steps, to make sure you understand the basic setup. Because once you understand the basics, you can do any problem that uses units in the future. You just have multiple steps to worry about, multiple applications of this technique. Dimensional analysis, unit analysis, factor label method, they all mean the same thing. Work problems with units. Make sure your units work out. Analyze the units. This is a technique commonly taught in chemistry, but it's not a chemistry technique. Also, this is not my technique. This is a common technique. You must learn how to do this. You have no choice in this. You have to do this. Problem-solving techniques. You pull the information out of it. You write down conversions. Then you assemble the information. So what do I need in terms of conversions? Well, centimeters to meters. Centi is a metric prefix. Meters is a metric unit. So we have to know the relationship between centimeter and meter. So we need to know what centi means. Now, centi doesn't change. Centi is a metric prefix. And 1 centimeter is 0.01 meters. If it were centigrams, 1 centigram is 0.01 grams. Centi doesn't change. Okay, so there's our conversion. We'll start with the given information, 23.44 centimeters. It's a common technique to start with the given information and then transform it. Also, I just wrote it over 1. The reason why I did that is conversions use fractions. And by taking that initial piece of information and writing it over 1, I clearly show my numerator and my denominator. Now, you don't have to do that. 5 over 1 is 5. But you'll see in a moment, I think this can be a useful technique for you. I also like to put information in parentheses. It's a problem-solving technique I've been using, I don't know how long, and it helps me see the pieces of all the information. It just separates it for me. You don't have to put parentheses around everything, and you don't have to write the 23.44 centimeters over 1. Now we're going to transform the centimeters into meters. So now we have to take our conversion and put it in the problem somehow. So a conversion is a fraction. I'm going to put the 1 centimeter either in the numerator or denominator. And I'm going to put the 0.01 meters either in the numerator or the denominator. Now, how do I know where to put those numbers? Centimeters in the given portion of the problem, 23.44 centimeters, that's in the numerator. Therefore, in my conversion, the centimeters goes in the denominator. Okay, now in my conversion, since I put centimeters in the denominator, the other unit in the relationship goes in the numerator. And now I'll place the numbers. 1 centimeter, 0.01 meters. Now here's where I think the technique of writing the 23.44 centimeters over 1 helps. Remember I said numerators and denominators. What's 5 divided by 5? Yeah, I know it's 1. Okay. So unit-wise, centimeters over centimeters, those units cancel. It's really a unit transformation, but the units cancel, and I'm left with units of meters. And not just units of meters, but meters in the numerator. Because that's what the problem asks for. It doesn't say how many 1 over meters are there. It's how many meters. That's how you check your work initially. Are your units there and are they in the right position? Now for the multiplication and division, we have to worry about significant figures. 23.44 has 4 significant figures. That metric relationship is exact. So it's a 4 significant figure relationship, you ignore the 1, multiplied by an exact relationship, and it means our answer has to have 4 significant figures in it. 0.2344 meters. Since this is a one-step conversion, we do have a common sense check. We've got 23.44 centimeters, which is a tiny unit. It's much smaller than a meter. There are a lot of centimeters in a meter. So if we go up to a larger unit, the number has to get smaller. And the 0.2344 is smaller than 23.44. Now maybe when I started this problem, you looked at that and you went, 1 centimeter equals 0.01 meters? Well, that was hard. Why not just go 100 centimeters in a meter? You know, that's correct. You set it up, you work it out, you get the same thing. Both of those setups are correct. Now, which one do I recommend? The recommendation has to do with skill level. And since this is a class that assumes a low skill set when you come in, and I don't mean that to be insulting, I just mean you're not supposed to be a chemistry expert when you come in here. It's assumed that you don't have a lot of chemistry background. You also may not have a lot of experience with the metric system. Okay, so if we're doing a conversion from a prefix to what we call a base unit, the base unit is meters in this case. So centi equals 1/100. In this class, I'm going to write all of my relationships that way. Centi equals 1/100. And it's for pattern matching reasons. The point of learning this technique is to then give you something that's more complicated. And when you're not sure what to do, you fall back on these basic techniques. Now, 100 centimeters in a meter. Absolutely correct. No problems with that. But let's try a different relationship. Let's try kilometers. Now kilo equals 1,000. So both of those conversions on the top are following a pattern. Prefix equals the numerical value. Centi equals 0.01. Kilo equals 1,000. Now that one on the bottom right, that's correct. I would personally never write it that way, 0.001 kilometers equals 1 meter, but it's correct. Something I see when people mix and match methods, in other words, they'll go a kilometer equals 1,000 meters, and then 100 centimeters equals a meter, I sometimes see things like this. And people will put the 1,000 for kilometers on the same side as kilo. And that's not correct. It's because kilo equals 1,000. The only way to get better at this is to practice it. And you have to force yourself to practice this method. It's not an easy technique if you haven't used it before. But it doesn't get easier unless you force yourself to do it.